Hello, this is Nathan from the Maker School, and I'm here with my friends Laëtitia and Payam. And today we are going to talk about the inverse square law. The law states that the intensity of a light source at a certain point is equal to the amount of light that the source produces divided by the square of the distance between the point and the source. But the mathematics of the law is not what we want to focus on right now. What we want is to understand the principle. You see, the inverse square law is about proximity. Proximity with the light source, I mean. Better. Roughly, the idea here is that if you double the distance between a subject and a light source, the light output will be divided by 4. As it travels, light covers an area that is larger and larger. At 2 meters, the light covers an area the size of A, but at 4 meters, it covers an area that is 4 times larger. Here is a reflector. For scale. Since we have a finite amount of light spread to fill that larger space, the subject is 4 times darker at 4 meters than it was at 2 meters. Okay, but in practice, how is that useful to us? Well, to begin with, if you look at the numbers, you will see that the light varies a lot more when you are close to the source, and almost not at all when you are far from it. That means that if you are recreating a source that is very far from you, like the sun, if you put your light source very close to the window, the light is going to vary on your subject as it gets closer. Because our brain are wired to recognize natural light a certain way, it's not gonna look real. It's gonna look cheap. Here's another setup, with the light much further away from the window. And the same goes the other way around, for a small source close to you, like a desk lamp. If you are reinforcing the lamp from far away, your large source will fill the whole room. But if the light source is closer, the light will fall off around the lamp. Look how Laëtitia fades into darkness when she gets away from the source. Whereas in this example, the light doesn't vary as much, and it looks like she's lit from further away. Also, you can use your knowledge of the law to build contrast. Look at me and this white background. The image is kind of flat, because there is not much contrast between my face and the wall. Doesn't look that good, right? It looks like the light did not change on me, but that the background got darker. But what we actually did is just get the light closer to me and close the aperture at the same time, so that the exposure on my face would remain the same. Plus, we can use the law to ballpark how much light we are losing when moving a source. Great! Getting familiar with the law will help you choose the right gear for the right space, something that can be quite hard when working in a larger set. This could potentially save you time and budget that could be spent elsewhere. Well, that's it for today. If there is some other subject you want us to talk about or explain, please leave us a comment so we can start working on it. And if you want to learn more, please consider subscribing and clicking the bell. We wouldn't say no to a thumbs up either, if you'd like. See you soon.